Tier City Expats Club is a non-profit social organisation and our speakers are volunteers. The club as such assumes no responsibility or liability for the professional reputation of or the quality of services provided by the speaker today.
G'day and Spidey Cap. Well, a lot of people are resting easier, even though you can hear them talking in the background. They are resting easier because Darren McGarry was here allaying their fears about the visas. So what is your great response to people's fit when they come to you and they're in fear around their visa?
The main reason is retirement visas now.
Yeah.
You know, my response to them is don't panic.
Mm.
You know, don't get yourself all overworked regarding it. Things can change. You know, things can be sorted. You don't have to concern yourself about having big problems with retirement visas. You just have to look at the rules. You have to understand the rules. You have to, if you don't understand them, come and see people who do know, you know.
And you had a number of really good points, that there's always a plan B.
Yeah, plan Bs are there, and, you know, that's what agents are there for, you know, for looking at ways that people can obtain the visa.
Mm. And I actually tell people who visit that sometimes you just have to allow yourself to be ripped off, and or to pay a fee for living in Thailand, or just allow people to overcharge you occasionally, or, you know, those sorts of things happen anywhere in any tourist town. And that's true of Thailand too, that sometimes you have to allow yourself to incur charges we might not have been expecting.
Yeah, obviously. I mean, it happens. I mean, I'm sure in Las Vegas you get that, you know. Mm. It happens here. But, you know, these people don't work here mainly because they want to, because most of the people are from northern Thailand. So they work here because they need to earn money.
So if you're being charged a fee you think you shouldn't be charged, you should just really let it go and just take it easy in life.
You come here to retire, you come here to be happy. Why get stressed? Mm. You know, you go on a BART bus, they charge you 10 baht, should have been 5, I don't know how much it costs, but what's the big deal?
Yeah.
You know, it's, why get your stress levels up and your blood pressure?
Mm.
You be here, be happy, understand the people, understand that maybe they could be poorer than you are. You know, if you was as poor as some of these people here, when you wake up in the morning, what's the first thing you think about?
What am I going to eat today?
Correct.
Am I going to eat today?
Yeah. Am I going to send money home to my family? Am I going to look after my child? Am I going to do this? Okay. Foreigners might be a bit selfish to say, well, that's not my problem. Well, yeah, it is. If you live in this country, you've got to accept that sometimes you might be overcharged, or, you know, just take it on the chin and just get on with it.
Well, it was a tremendously informative talk. I mean, people have been here for a long time, really got value out of it. One of the things that struck me is people have been, you know, with the 800,000 baht in the bank account for how long now? Does it have to be there in advance?
2 months before.
Right? Only 2 months now?
Yeah, it's 2 months before the first visa. Yeah, 2 months before, and it has to stay in the bank 3 months after. So 800,000 2 months before and 3 months after.
So not 8 months, it used to be a longer period beforehand, didn't it?
It used to be 3 months. Yeah, but now they change it to 2 months before, 3 months after, and then you, for the rest of the 9 months of the year, you can't let it drop below 400,000 baht.
The other thing that was new to us was this idea that you had to show an active bank account that showed that you were taking money out every month to live on.
Yeah, this was a preemptive thing that I've just advised people to do. If you got 800,000 baht and it's been stuck in the bank and some people can afford to just leave it there, okay. If you get challenged, you may be challenged what you're living on. Okay, that's fine. Take something that shows what you're living on.
Mm.
Be it pension paper, or be it you've got a separate bank account. Where
and so how much are they expecting that you would be living off in a month, or is there no figure?
65,000 baht a month, maybe.
Well, we know that. That's a threshold, but a lot of people live off a lot less than that in a month here.
Exactly, of course they do. So you live off what you want.
Right.
You know,
so if you're living off 20,000 baht a month, is that enough?
Behave yourself. even we couldn't do that. But no, the situation is that there's people that live off income that is derived from working without a work permit.
Mm.
So if you've got 800,000 baht in the bank and it's just sat there doing nothing, the old way of thinking used to be, well, that 800,000 really is, some of it is for you to live on. So if you're not using that money, what are you living on? So it's a good idea to have, you know, that proof in place. Well, here's my ATM slips, this is what I use, or this is my pension statement from overseas. That's where I get my income from, you know. So make sure just get your things together.
Well, it's a very informative talk, and hopefully we're going to have a look at it. Hopefully it'll be okay to post online. Hopefully we didn't say too much out of line. But it's a great joy and blessing to have you here. And I know people, I mean, it was a long, lot of Q&A, and it was a long, so it was really, really valued by people. So thank you. And just give us, everybody, if you need a plan B, this is your guy. What's your website?
www.kivisathailand.com.
And he's a good guy, so I personally recommend him as somebody to talk to who will, you know, really is concerned to make people sleep at night. Yeah. So it's goodbye and sweaty cup from us, and rest easy tonight.